A piece of history is here in Huntsville. The plane that led the D-Day invasion in 1944 was nearly lost, but thanks to the commemorative Air Force, it is now fully restored and taken to the sky once again. Our Ken McCoy has more.
Over 75 years ago on June 6, 1944, That's All Brother led the main airborne invasion of Normandy.
Our goal actually was to resurrect the airplane and actually to get it to look exactly like it did on D-Day.
Fast forward to today, and that same plane, yes, that exact plane, has made a special landing here.
This is That's All Brother, the C-47 that was the lead airplane that flew on D-Day. And what it's going to be doing, it's going to be given tours, and it's going to be given flights to anybody who wants it. So, kind of a unique opportunity that not a lot of people get, especially in Huntsville, Alabama.
And it's completely restored.
We've made a radome that goes on the bottom of the airplane, and when it's on static display back at home base, we put the radome back onto the bottom of the airplane. So externally, that's about it. Internally, basically the only thing we're missing at the navigator station right now, there's the Rebecca Eureka scope is there. The G scope is there. What we're looking for still, and hope we can find one someday, is the radar scope that goes with the SCR 717 radar.
Mitchell also explained how Operation Neptune actually worked.
What the Neptune was actually the airdrop portion of D-Day. And you can see all these points right here are multiple bases that the airplanes had to take off from, since there was 800 airplanes.
And they also had a dog.
You can see the pilot right here. You can see he's got something in his arm, and what that is a little black dog, and they actually took the dog on the mission because it was a squadron mascot there.
For more on this story and how you can see That's All Brother, head over to fox54.com. For Fox 54 News, I'm Ken McCoy.